Hi, everyone. I'm filming a short iMac segment with Adam B. You see, what happened was is that I heavily upgraded an old, about a 7-year-old grape iMac with a gig of RAM and a 128 gigabyte hard drive. It was actually done by Adam B, and we filmed it, but my camera crashed. We lost the file. Anyway, this old G3 iMac was a 400 megahertz G3, and a friend just gave me a 500 megahertz G3. So basically, we're going to do a bit of a transplant and move the hard drive from one machine to another, specifically from this grape iMac to this blue iMac. Basically, we're going to make the blue iMac G3 500 megahertz with a gig of RAM, a 128 gigabyte hard drive, and FF class iMac. And the surgery is going to be done by my friend, and no one else could do this with this level of efficiency but Adam B. So this is Adam B.
Hi, this is Adam B. I'm coming to you live from fabulous New York City, home of big signs, little people, and big posters. Actually, no, we're here with Al, and we're going to be... What am I doing with this? We're going to be just doing this transplant stuff. Let me get my screwdriver.
All right, just a little bit of a warning and a heads up. Don't be scared of the various cracking sounds that the plastics from the iMac emits as
Adam B.
That's going
to be my neck.
As Adam B. does the surgery on these fine, classic pieces of Apple computer hardware, which still run flawlessly. And I even shoehorned OS 10.49 on these things, and they actually ran fine as long as there was plenty of RAM and a fast hard drive. Anyway, over to Adam B. Okay, the patient has now been turned upside down. Adam B. is going to attempt to do this sideways so we can see the fine art of opening up an iMac.
Well, first I'm going to get the guts out. Well, the movable guts.
We are now doing the gut removal process. That'll be after we eat at Taco Bell later.
I had that for lunch.
You did?
Yeah, let's have real Mexican.
The gig of RAM has now been successfully removed.
And now for a trip to the airport.
The airport card is now being meticulously, carefully, delicately, I said delicately, removed.
All right, and now we just start screwing around. Or unscrewing around, as the case may be.
Adam B., with his power drill, a man with his tools.
Yes, a lot of people go screwing around on a Friday night. This is what we do.
That's a true artist at work. I mean, look at the form. Look at the precision. Look at the stupidity that's coming out of us at this time. It's ridiculous. How you doing there, Adam?
I'm fine. How are you?
What happens next, doctor?
Get your earplugs.
Ah!
Well, that wasn't so bad since we had opened this one once before.
Correct.
Hi, how are you?
That was a silly visual, but I'm sure a few folks will like it anyway.
And I hope you cut it out of the file.
No.
Please.
Ah, is this the radiation shield?
Yes, actually it is.
It is?
Yes. It keeps the electromagnetic radiation that all these parts inside prevents them from screwing around with your cell phones and cordless phones and pacemakers and stuff.
Just so you know, folks, with that radiation shield on the iMac, if there's a nuclear holocaust and there's like an EM blast, an electromagnetic pulse, your iMac will still be running iTunes, so you'll be okay.
Well, the speakers will have melted, but... you can plug in the headphones if they survive the blast.
Whatever. Okay, the radiation shield is now off, exposing the motherboard and the guts of the machine. It's actually the architecture of the iMac. It's really pretty well done. It's very compact, and it's relatively efficient. Let's take a look inside. And there we have the guts of this grape iMac, which is about 7 years old. Nice. And Adam, what screws are we removing at this point?
The last thing I really need to take out is just these four screws that are holding the hard drive in place.
Okay.
Here comes the drive. Doo, 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 doo. Here comes the drive. And I say, it's a Seagate. I'm done taking stuff out of here. Now we're going to move this one to the side and open up the new one and start swapping parts.
Okay, well, we've effectively seen how to take it apart. We don't have to film it again. And then we'll just film the button-up process, which actually I can just play backwards.
You just play me going backwards, yeah.
Wow, that was not done with an audio processing program. That's amazing. We're now going to film Adam B. opening up the case on the blue iMac. The reason why is because the case on the blue iMac has never been opened, so it's going to deliver the most painful impact of sound. So over to Adam B.
All right. This case hasn't been off here since it was put on in a factory in China, probably, in the year 2000. So all these little tabs in here.
You're going to be getting it off now, right?
I hope. Hopefully in one piece and all that. Nothing else we got to spare over there, and I got a couple of these at home. What's the best way to grip this? What is the best way to grip this? I may have to pry it. Really anticlimactic.
That was it?
Except maybe for this.
Ah! Adam B. doing physical comedy. You're seeing it here on YouTube. Unbelievable, folks.
And now, a musical interlude.
Adam B. is now reinserting the brain of the machine. Gang, please. Gang, please. Thank you for the gang.
It's actually not so much the brain, but the mind. The brain is the 68040. What? No, it's the G3 chip that's in there. That's the brain because it does the thinking. This is the mind because this is what it does the thinking with.
Ooh. I just got pwned. Whatever.
Where did that come from? No.
Adam B. activates the computer's speech synthesis capabilities, specifically text to speech, from the terminal. This is kind of cool.
A wave hello to Alfred's YouTube subscribers.
Nice.
Bite me.
Knock it off.
Whatever.
Hey, that's my line. Knock it off.
Knock it off.
Oh, God. Good night.
Bye.
The fully recovered patient is working just fine. We now have an FF class iMac. Blue, G3, 500 megahertz, with 1 gig of RAM. Here it is. Pretty perky. I use a program called Dave to connect to my Windows 2003 server, and no problem at all with that. And now for signs of things to come. I did get a replacement mouse for the Lisa, which is there. So, very soon now, as I've promised you all, you will see that machine booting. And here's the extra special bonus. I dug through storage, and I found the very, very special cable for the next cube, which is here. With this cable in hand, which provides power and video signal to the monitor, you will see the next cube as well. So, stay tuned, and thanks for watching.
And this concludes our show.